In this video, I'm going to show you how to change the font size on your WordPress website. Let's go. So I'm going to be demonstrating the font size change on both the editors inside WordPress. The first one being the block editor, which you can see right here. And the second one being the classic editor. And right now I have just one sentence on both the posts. This is a sentence and this is a sentence, or this is a paragraph. Sorry. If I refresh this page, you can see the block editor. This is a sentence. And if I go here, I'll refresh this. This is a paragraph. Both have similar sizes, but both are paragraphs. So no control over changing the font size. The first thing we can do to change the font size is by using headings. Now, as I said, this is a paragraph block. If you go here in the list, you can see this is a paragraph block, or you can just click on it and you'll see this icon right here, which means it's a paragraph block. So we need to change the type of block it is to change the font size, and we can convert this into a heading block. So I'll click here, transform to heading, and now this becomes a heading. And now I have more control over how I want to change the font size of the heading. So I can make it an H1, which is the largest font size. I can make it an H2, H3. The bigger the number with the H, the smaller the font size. So let's stick with H3 and I'll update the post. The same thing I can do here. I just need to highlight the text first and then go here and then just make sure to select the right font size or the right heading type and click update. And once the page is updated, I'll just go to the block editor. I'll refresh the page here and you see this is a sentence is now big in size. If I go to the classic editor, refresh the page here, this is a paragraph. So this is the first step to increasing font size inside WordPress with the block editor. Let's talk about the second method. So talking about the second method to change font size in WordPress, this method only works with the block editor. So let me demonstrate that for you very quickly. Now, if you want to just change the font size and don't want to change the block, you want to keep it as paragraphs, it's actually possible. I just wanted to highlight the difference between the block editor and the classic editor if you use headings. So let's say you're using the paragraph block, similar to what I am doing here. I'll click here, and it's apart from these options here, you'll also have block based options here. So what you can do is you can see right here, the typography size option is already present. All you have to do is click on the appropriate size you like and the font will be changed to it. So if I click small, it's small. If I medium, click medium, it's medium, large, and even XL. So let's say if I want the large size for this, I can just update the post, go here, and this is the old one. I'll refresh it and now it's a new font size based on what we selected here. Now let's say you want to go back to the default settings. All you have to do is click the three dotted menu here and reset this option. Now you might be wondering, is it possible to change the font size in the classic editor without using headings? Yes, it is possible, and that's the topic of method number three. So let's talk about method number three. So let's talk about method number three. And method number three is by using a plugin. And the plugin we can use is called Advanced Editor Tools. It's a plugin by Automattic. That means the company that manages WordPress. So it's an official plugin. So no need to worry about any kind of security issues. So Advanced Editor Tools, this is the plugin. Make sure to just take a look at the icon. 2 million plus installs. It's a very popular plugin. Let's install the plugin. Wait for it to finish. Let's also activate the plugin. All right, so the plugin is now installed. Now, before I use the plugin in the classic editor or the block editor, let's look at the settings because there might be some things you need to change. This plugin works with both the block editor and the classic editor. So if I go here, you'll see two set of settings, the block editor and the classic editor. Now, if I go to the classic editor, you'll see this kind of menu option here, which means that this is the kind of menu you'll see in the classic editor when this plugin is active. More importantly, you'll notice that the font family and the font sizes buttons are already present. So when you make changes to the fonts or want to make changes to the fonts inside the classic editor, these options are already configured for the classic editor. But if you go back to the block editor, you'll see that these blocks are not added here. So what we'll need to do first is just add both of these blocks to this menu, save our settings so that we can actually use this block or use these settings. So let's clearly find out where these are. I'll just look for it. This is the font sizes. I'll just drag it here and let go here. And I'll also find the font family. I'll just drag it here and leave it here. Now, these are the only two, I'd say, buttons or widgets or whatever we want to have, the font family and the font sizes. Once this is done, you can just scroll to the bottom of the page, click save changes. So the changes are saved. Let's first go to the classic editor here and let's change and let's use this. So for that, what I'll have to do is first I'll refresh the page so that you see a next new set of options, and I'll just delete the entirety of this sentence. I'll just type this once again. This is a sentence And now you already see all these options available. I can just change the font size by using these options. So 13 pixels, the font size was set to 13. Now I can do it, set it to 10, 12, 14, 18. Similar to how you would edit the document, you can edit the font size here. If I update it here, I'll go back, I'll refresh this. Instantly, you see the changes. If I go back, I'll select this sentence again. I'll make it 36, really big. I'll update this. I'll go back, refresh, and now this is the change reflected live. So this is how you use the plugin that we just talked about in the classic editor. In the block editor, the process is slightly different. Inside the block editor, I won't be able to use the regular paragraph block. I have to use a new block that's added by the plugin. So what I'll do is, I've already refreshed the page. I'll just add that new block. It's called the classic paragraph. So I'll type forward slash here, type classic. And you see the second one, the classic paragraph option. Once I click it, you'll see a similar interface popping up that you saw in the classic editor or the old editor. So now it's the very similar interface. So nothing to worry about, nothing to figure out. Just type a sentence. So let's say this is a new sentence. And the exact same thing can be done here. I'll just go here, select the entirety, and I can change the font size here. I'll just update the post, go here and refresh. And now you see the new sentence pop up here with a different font size. So that's how easy it is to change font sizes with the Advanced Editor plugin. But there's another method you can use, which uses CSS, but I think it's the most powerful method. So let's talk about that method now. So the next and the most robust method you can utilize to increase font size in WordPress is by using the plugin called WP Code. So I'm already in the plugin section, add new section. I'll search for WP Code. And WP Code is a plugin that helps you create and manage code snippets on your site. Let's install the plugin, and by using the WP Code plugin, we'll create a small snippet that'll apply to the entirety of our website. And with that simple code snippet, it'll increase the font size of all the paragraphs. Now, it might sound scary, but it's absolutely, absolutely easy to follow, even if you have no experience in writing code. So WP Code is now installed and activated. You will also see the code snippets menu appear here. Don't worry, it's very simple. Just go to the code snippets, go and click the add snippets button. We'll create a new custom snippet, add your custom code snippet. We'll click it, and this will open the interface. All you have to do is first name the snippet. I'll name it big font size, and I'll choose the CSS snippet, because this is a CSS code that we're writing, and the code is very simple to follow. P space curly brackets, it'll automatically add the ending curly bracket, press enter to split it into two lines. We'll type in font forward slash or hyphen, sorry, size. Let's say we want to make it 36 px and semicolon. Now, whatever font size you want to have for the paragraph, you can add it here. I'm just adding 36 as an example. Once you're done, just click this button, which makes it active. Also save the snippet. Now there are plenty of other options inside WP Code. You can scroll here and you see a lot of different options. This is advanced use of WP Code. It's a very powerful plugin, but for now we don't need to use all of these features. This piece of code will make the font size bigger. Once this is done, I'll go here. I'll just refresh the page just for safety, both these pages, and go back here. All right. I'll just delete this, and okay, let's convert to classic block. And I'll delete this block. I'll just type in a new block once again. And what I'll do is, since I'm just typing it in, it'll be a paragraph block. So this is the newest sentence. This is the new sentence. If I'll update the post here, you see this is a simple block that I've just created. I haven't made any changes. Let's go back here. I'll refresh this page. And you see the font size is quite large because we've set the font size to 36 pixels. Now, if I go here and let's say, for example, I want to override this, then using the typography options on the page, you can actually override this. So you can say this will be overridden. Oops. This will be changed. Let's make it simple. And I'll just click here and choose a medium size for the font, or let's keep it small just to have a differentiation. Updated. Let's go back, refresh the page, and this font size does not change because I've overridden it with the typography options. Inside the classic editor, I've just typed in a new sentence. This is a new sentence. I'll update it once again. It's updated. It's a paragraph block. Make sure it's paragraph because that's what we're working with right now. I'll go here. I'll refresh the page. And now you see it's again a big size. And if I want to override this, I'm not sure if it works in the classic editor, but I can just copy this. Let's try this. and select this. And if I make this, let's say, to 18 pixels, I'll just save the page. I'll refresh this. So it definitely works. So if I override the settings using the plugin that we installed, it will override the default setting that we created. Similarly, it happens in the block editor as well. In the block editor, you don't need to use the classic paragraph or the classic paragraph block. You can just override the settings using the block options right here. So these are all the options that you have to update your font size or increase the font size in WordPress. Definitely check out WP Code. It's the most flexible and versatile solution, and you can have multiple, I'd say, categories of different text that you can modify. It's a very powerful plugin. I've just maybe not even scratched the surface of what it can do for your website. And of course, if you have any questions on how to increase the font size in WordPress or any other topic related to WordPress, the comment section is open. Leave your questions there or your feedback there. My name is Yuvraj. Make sure you subscribe before you leave and watch a cat video on the internet. And I'll see you in the next video. Take care.